I'm Keiko and I'm a holistic health coach at ktmholistichealth.com. So today I'm going to show you which HTMA markers to look at to get insight about your adrenal function. So please remember to correlate lab data with a person and their complaints. So just a quick background on the adrenals. So adrenals have three main functions. Number one is to regulate blood sugar and inflammation. And number two is to regulate mineral balances, particularly sodium and potassium. And number three, it produces a variety of hormones. Your adrenal glands are constantly responding to stressors, both internal and external. Internal would be things like pathogens, infections, and toxic metals. And external can be things like rattlesnakes and arguments. Now let's look at the markers. The first two we're going to look at is sodium and potassium. So if sodium is 25 milligram percent or less, you're looking at lowered adrenal function. And if potassium is 10 milligram percent or less, you're also looking at lowered adrenal function. Now let's look at the two ratios to get further insight into your adrenal function. So the first ratio we're going to look at is the sodium to potassium. This is known as the adrenal strength indicator, or vitality ratio, or the stress ratio. So the ideal is 2.5, and if it's over, we're looking at strength or stress depending on how far it is from the ideal. So the further away, it's going to be higher stress. And below it, we're looking at weakness or burnout. And the further away you are from ideal, you're gonna be further burnt out. The next ratio we'd be looking at would be the sodium to magnesium. And this is known as the adrenal ratio. And the ideal is 4.17, which is right here. And if it's over it, you're looking towards more activity or overactivity, and under is underactivity. And again, this is a spectrum, so it just depends on how far away you are from the ideal. So two things to note. If the sodium to magnesium ratio is below 1, that would really indicate that you've got pretty exhausted adrenals, and you generally won't see much toxic metals being eliminated from your hair. The other thing is, since both of these ratios utilize sodium, you want to make sure that if you have a water softener or swim in seawater, that you are rinsing your hair in distilled or reverse osmosis water to make sure there's no sodium contamination. Make sure to take this information within a bigger context. Since I am trained as an FDNP, I have also run other functional lab tests to correlate the information I get from the HTMA to get a better picture. So I have used the DUT, which is the dry urine test for comprehensive hormone, as well as the BioHealth HPA stress profiles using saliva. And they correlate really well with the adrenal function HTMA markers. So if you'd like to learn more about my HTMA service, please visit my website. You can always schedule a discovery call and talk to me. If you like this video, please let me know by liking it and making a comment. Please have a beautiful day, and thanks for watching.